How did you develop this interest? I read somewhere it was your mother who really pushed you to an interest in physics.
Yeah, she was a learned teacher who couldn't go for taking up as a job as a teacher. So we are five girls and one boy. She gave equal education for all of us and wanted all the girls to be working lady. And that's how I took up the engineering part, then came to the science field and working as a scientist.
And what were some of the challenges you faced, Dr. Thomas, being a woman?
Yeah, it's a challenging journey as far as science is concerned. But science doesn't have gender. So we need to master the science. If you are technologically, your know-how is clear, if you are competent in that field, then you, what you need to have is your self-motivation and then situational awareness. So you need, you have the natural brain, then you, what you need is an emotional intelligence, then you are there as an empowered woman. Nobody can challenge you. I can 100% say that this field is so well placed for women.
How do you see the description as India's missile woman? That's how you're described all the time. Do you think of yourself as India's missile woman? Sounds very dangerous and scary.
No. It's affectionate words said about me. I take it with the affection and love for the whole country people.
Your mentor was former President Abdul Kalam. He actually placed you on the Agni 4 missile program. Talk a little bit about working with him.
Yeah, it's a great honor to feel that we have worked with Dr. Kalam. When I joined, he was director. And he has an open mind. As a junior scientist, he doesn't make any description with an expert or a junior scientist. And he always tells us to learn science, learn, get knowledge. That is what he used to say. Even as a president also, I have seen him. You should read this, you should read that. That is the way he used to talk to scientists.
How would you encourage more girls to take interest in science?
I think already the step is on. I think the women have, girls are taking the step towards science and mathematics. It's a very welcome step. When I compare with what we joined, it was hardly four or five scientists. Now we are having more than hundreds of scientists in this field. So the percentage has increased from 3% to more than 15%. That's a big bonus for all the women. And this is a field where if you are knowledgeable, nobody can challenge you. And you need to become what you are. So just learn. Learn and get the knowledge. Today, this world of knowledge all around you. It's a matter of your own dedication to know the things.
One last question. What were some of the hardships you had to face? Because as you said, at your time, it was different. There were very few women in what's called hardcore science. What was, you know, did you face resistance? Did you feel resistance from male colleagues, from outside world? How was the reaction of society, of your workplace?
It's something like, as I initially mentioned, science has no gender. It's what we are all considered as scientists. So in our DRDO, we didn't find any difference. It's one step of what your self-motivation to move ahead. That is what it matters. If you withdraw from things, then you are nowhere near in the path. So always be bold enough to take. Because we do work with science, which is not even proven to us. The technologies which are first time developed in the country. So there will be always challenges, failures. You have to, your mind has to be set to see that things are going to happen good for you. So that is the way you have to take it. So there is always a challenge when failure happens. Always women take a step back. No, nothing is working for me. That's not the way we should take a step forward, and success will be yours.
And your last words to this full packed audience here that's come to hear you today. The missile woman, supposedly named after Mother Teresa, is that correct?
Yeah. Tessie, the word means Teresa, that's so.
And do you feel more optimistic about women in science? Because even 15%, that number you gave is not great, ma'am.
Yeah, it's true. But today the school education, what I'm seeing, is they are enthusiastic in learning the science. There are a few role models which is coming, and then they are feeling encouraged. And everything has to start from the whole family. If my mother could support me in whatever I want to learn, engineering, because the time when I joined for engineering, they feel, what will a girl go and do for engineering? So that feeling should not be from the home, the family. Within there, it should be determined that your daughter can become what a son can become, or more than that. So that should be the spot.